This video is about setting up the steering pad 900F with the current version of the firmware. The first things to do is to connect the steering pad to the computer. After the assembly, it should be on the testing software. Before uploading the final firmware, I need to copy the values from the thresholds variable. I set these values during the board setup, and they are necessary for the Pro Micro to recognize the buttons correctly. In the test script, I select the entire thresholds array and copy it. Then, in the final firmware script called Steering Pad 900F Board 3, I locate the thresholds variable and replace it with the values from the test script. The firmware expects certain memory addresses on the Pro Micro to hold calibration values. These values must be present on the first boot. To force them to exist, I enable this is first time uploading variable by setting it to true. Now I can upload the firmware to the controller. Once the upload is complete, the default values are stored in memory, but at this stage they will still reset every time the controller is plugged in. To fix that, I set is first time uploading back to false and upload the firmware again. This step is only needed once. After this, any future firmware upload will work correctly because the Pro Micro already has the calibration values stored. After uploading it again with a variable set to false, the controller is ready to use. Let's dive into the menu and see what we have here and what we can control. If I press and hold the T button, the menu is activated. Force feedback, active, yes. If I click change, the settings switch to no. The T button cycles through all the available options. And when I click exit, it asks whether to save the changes. If I click yes, all changes are stored. If I select no, all changes are discarded. When I return to the menu, it stays on the last position to make adjustments easier. But if the controller is turned off and on again, the menu always starts from the beginning, which is force feedback active. This enables or disables the force feedback. The next setting adjusts the force level, but the steering wheel isn't calibrated yet and I need that to change the number, so I will come back here later. Next up is the brake pedal linearity. I can choose between linear, is out or is in. I will leave it on linear. And same goes for the accelerator pedal. Next are the calibration options. First, the steering wheel. Entering this menu, the controller asks for the 0° position, which is full left. The number should increase as you go to the right and decrease to the left. If this isn't happening on yours, your magnets might be reversed. The poles are facing the wrong way and need to be fixed. So, I go to the 0 position. But I set it just a little bit to the right, to avoid signal noise. You will not notice it in use. I save it like that, and it asks for the 90° position. Now all positions should be precise. I rotate and save. I repeat this for each 90° steps until the end. At the final step, I do the same as in the first, leaving a tiny margin before the maximum. If you rotate almost to the maximum and the numbers don't change much, or the opposite happens in the beginning of the rotation, your sensor might not be centered between the magnets. When done, I save the settings and the steering is now calibrated. This only needs to be done once, but the calibration menu is always available if needed. The next is the brake pedal. It starts by asking for the up position. I like to press it slightly, like as before, just to avoid noise and ensure it reads the minimum value when fully released. At the maximum position, I release it just a bit as well, so it always gives a stable full press reading. The accelerator pedal follows the same process. Start, press slightly. Set, press fully, release slightly. Set. That's it. Once the menu cycles through all options, it returns to the start. Pressing exit prompts me to save, I press yes, and all settings are stored in the controller's memory for the next time. If I open Game Controller in Windows, I should already see it listed as Arduino Micro. Double-clicking it opens the Properties panel, where I can test if everything is working. The steering wheel controls the X axis, moving left and right. The accelerator and brake pedal moves the Z and Y axis, respectively. And then the buttons, 1, 2, 3, 3 triggers on release, because long press opens the menu, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Button 13 also triggers on release. This allows it to be combined with the plus and minus buttons for the cruise control speed setting. 13 plus 9 triggers 14, and 13 plus 11 triggers 15. Before launching a game, now that the steering wheel is calibrated, I go back into the menu to set the force feedback level. The steering wheel itself is used to set the number. That's why it needed to be calibrated first. I prefer to use it at 80, but this depends on the game, the USB port, and even the computer, since the power comes from USB only. Set, exit, yes. It's finally done and ready to use in a game. I really hope you enjoyed this series and learned something useful. I'm already thinking about how to improve the controller and what a second series could include. Of course, any next steps need to make sense. They should add real value to the project, not just please the algorithm. If you have suggestions, ideas you'd like to see implemented, or even other portable, backpack-compatible controllers, feel free to leave a comment and share them. They might happen. I already have a few ideas myself. As you can now understand, there's nothing out of this world in this project, and I'm expecting many of you to actually embark on this adventure. Being a maker and being able to create what we need is an amazing feeling, and sometimes all we need to start is to copy a cool project. After that, there are no limits. So, at this point, thank you for watching, like, share and subscribe, and I hope to have you in the future.